All these guys participated in MK Ultra. You see right here. I got to move myself away. These guys participated in MK Ultra. They were involved in MK Ultra. I met them in Moscow. I met them throughout. This is the thing. I met them throughout Africa. One is from Ivory Coast. Another one is from Tanzania. They literally were in the circle of Putin, Lavrov, top Russian circle of people. I should say Illuminati, Russian Illuminati, let's say, delegation or whatever. But you know what? I was here at this place. I visited this guy here during MK Ultra. They delivered me to him. No. Dar es Salaam. Namastarimo. This guy is from, it says right there, apparently that he is from Tanzania. But so it doesn't matter, you know. Here you have listed Tanzania, Zambia, Ivory Coast. That doesn't matter. You see, the thing is, it does not matter. I was, everything you see at the Moscow, meeting these guys literally in Russia. And the thing is, they like threatened me. They're going to go and they're going to do that and so on. What you see right there with the casket, the funeral with the casket that you see there. The funeral with the casket was already reorchestrated during a...
Like Roblox, the sandbox allows you to build your own 3D games using its Game Maker application. Unlike Roblox, the sandbox...
Mwili wa Mtanzania Neme Kaseto kilichopo wilaya ya Rungwe mkoani Mbeya. Mwili huo uliwasili katika uwanja wa ndege wa JK Nyerere Dar es Salaam asubuhi ya Ijumaa Januari 27, 2023 ukitokea Urusi.
I like this picture here because in the background is entire landscape of where I would be delivered already since probably maybe even 1995. This is one of the oldest locations involved in MK Ultra. Whose funeral did I participate in? I have no idea. The thing is, the three guys didn't like me at all. So it could be that this is one of those funeral, Russian funerals, even I'm going to say so, American, British, German funerals that go in line with a psychiatric label which I received in 2013-2012 as a paranoid schizophrenic, but basically my seeing something that doesn't exist. So I see, because the three brothers were enlisted in a Wagner military, that my black brothers are paying their dues to Russian universities through a different means. If they could already accomplish something like this video, for their Russian masters, it appears, it would be a really great thing. But when I stated Russian masters, you know, and I did point out quite a few issues already about Africa. This is weird and crazy stuff, obviously. I'm not here to expand wounds even more. You know, I don't want to get further by pointing out how there was a great deal of racism apparently that went on when against African people on Ukrainian side, when a war broke out, is something that we still need to learn about what exactly went on. And then on the other side, with some African guys right there, being projected is killed. Therefore, taking arms for the sake of Russia against Ukraine is so crazy, so insane, that it actually scares the shit out of me. You know, not because I would be afraid of African people. It's some other issues. In a way, yes, afraid of African people. Afraid of African people because of what I'm about to tell you next. This is Tanzania here. I have this global map. Obviously, you know where the Africa is, I'm sure. If not, inform yourself. There is an African continent. Then, you know, that's Russia. And you know already where is Ukraine. By now, you should. U.S., South America. There is Australia down under. What scares me about the African people is that the children of the poverty, of exploitation, as African people are, with their inability to refrain itself from, well, definitely from participating in wars, I should say, taking sides in wars on other continents. In this case, this is a European continent, but it could be the same if they would participate somewhere in South America or somewhere in Asia, let's say. I'm going to put it this way. The people who have no food, the people that many of them starve, are in great need of education, prosperity, work, have been extremely disadvantaged due to exploitation. And, or foremost, due to unwillingness to follow one China example, where the growth of the population was completely restrained. When compared to China, Africa had a super, super, super enormous potential due to its natural resources, even size. But the thing is that, how can I say, it's gone, and the poverty along with the population growth is simply increasing. It's completely out of hand. Now, instead of to follow example and work with the people that willingly so would try, do their best to help you out so that, you know, that's what scares me, because so that the whole world would not slip into the era of what used to be known as colonization. We have this disparity contesting literally on other continents, which the worst to participate in war, if you are a African person, is the one in Europe. This is like probably the worst place, especially in Ukraine, that never participated in any kind of colonial issues. In Eastern Europe, this is not a place to be. Simple as this. It's not a place to be. It's not a place where you do want to advertise Vladimir Putin. Don't want to do that. I told you already in videos, in videos earlier, that seeing yourself in anything other than what you are is gonna deliver you colonial system back throughout entire Africa. Africa is the most vulnerable. Next to South America, Africa is the most vulnerable. Africa is more vulnerable than South America. It's more undeveloped. It's a bigger disparity, technological disadvancement. It's really, really difficult situation for people in Africa. And, you know, once you're going to start seeing yourself in somebody else other than yourself, especially that be in Russia, you're fucking dead. In Africa, you would die. And along the painful death, you're going to take along entire world with it. You're going to pull entire world to the hell with it. We're all going to fucking die if you feel better now. See, the thing is, you have to understand what you refer to as a colonizers. You know, as a colonizers, you have here United Kingdom, you have here Germany, and you have Belgium here, and you have France, and so on, and Spain, and Portugal, and Italy. All these countries somehow had to settle for peace. They had to settle for the post-World War II treaty, and they were forced to comply with what United Nations charters dictated after the World War II. Yes. Obviously, guys, I'm trying to tell you down in Africa is that ex-colonialists, or those, it's not necessarily only ex-colonialists, it's other countries that have interest in exploitation also, are not going to send, let's say, a team of people from Spain or Portugal or France or Belgium or Netherlands to colonize you. They're not going to, British are not just going to land here with a boat and say, oh, well, you know, we're back, I'm sorry, but, you know, from now on, I don't know, from now on, Nigeria or Cameroon or whatever country here, Angola or whatever, you are again part of a British imperial state or whatever. They're not going to do this. If you're waiting for Germans to return or Belgians to return to Congo, Germans to Namibia, whatever, that's not going to happen. They have trade relations with you. They've been nice. They're helping you out in many ways. Indeed, they do. Indeed. Indeed, they do. But you do need more help. You need a whole lot of help, and more than help, you need one China policy. You need to self-restrain your growth, population growth, expenditure. You need to upgrade. You need to level up. Work with people that are there to help you out. And I did spoke about that issue. Once you will, you know, let's go back to this stuff here. Definitely is a hope news. I hoped I'm not going to see that kind of news. I didn't. Yeah, I was when they were threatening me that they're gonna fuck me and this and that, I was laughing at them. I didn't take them seriously. You know, I didn't know what the fuck this guy was talking about when I was drugged up and so on. You know, you talk whatever you want, you know. But it was Medvedev that was collecting the signatures from people, and this guy, Lavrov, sort of assured me, would not be killed. The biggest threat here, for me to tell you, to finish this, this guy is here. You see this? Let me demonstrate you. See this here? The one they're going to send first to Africa, you know who's going to be? The one whom you trust the most. The one who never was in Africa, but also was imperial. It was a big fucking imperialism in Russia, even called Soviet Union. Not only from Tsar Peter and so on, from, you know, there was a big fucking slavery in here. Asian people can tell you also about how many were deleted from the face of Earth. They can tell you maybe about how eastern part of China already was in the hands of North Korea, in the hands of Russia. There's a lot you can learn about from these nations here that border Russia. The Ukrainians apparently have the same DNA as the Russians, the same people. Look how they treat them. If you think they're going to treat you any different, they're not going to come here first. You're not going to see Germans. You're not going to see British. You're not going to see Belgians and French. They're going to send somebody else. The one you like, the one you love, the one you already have give green light. It's going to be Ruski that's going to come. And when the Ruski comes, you know what's going to happen with you guys? First thing that's going to happen is you're going to get more and more competition from the West, from those that had to sign treaties, post-World War II treaties, but will be become increasingly worried and sorry for the Russian troops to participate in African world of affairs. And what will happen is, it will be more and more unhappiness in the region. It will be more and more competition. And finally, it's going to happen, as Vladimir Putin already demonstrated me, the map on how this is going to look like. It will be a division of Africa, of the African continent, again, into the colonial sub-states. Then you will be celebrating a new French passport, German passport, Belgian or Russian passport, or whatever fucking passport. And you're gonna wave your ass goodbye to yourself. Your new will never meet your old yourself, because you will be erased. You won't look what's happening in Ukraine, and I guarantee you, you are never ever gonna save yourself from the clutches of slavery this time. There will be no escape for you. This is just one mistake you're gonna make, and this is gonna be your last one. So, these guys here, these guys are not dead. Generosity of Vladimir Putin, Lavrov, Medvedev looked for something else. They looked for, what a pretty picture, isn't it? Luckily, it's not somewhere in Africa. Luckily, it's not. But in the future, when you will get new passport, just remember this picture, because they can turn you into this so quickly. The population which they are tutoring you about, how it is necessary and still is in your hands, still you can do at your convenience. You can still do a China policy. And instead of population growth of the population, grow education, economic relations with those that are trying to help you out. Once you get out of hands, you can kiss your ass goodbye. What is about this news here? About this, what is scary about this news? Do you know what scary is about this news? Medvedev was collecting this here, this. He was collecting this here, Tanzania. He was collecting, I don't know, what did I say earlier? Zambia. He was collecting Ivory Coast. So he was collecting people they would list as dead throughout the Africa so that he could get as many as possible yourself to follow this kind of dream. Because these guys are alive. So this actually, it's a good account. It's like a good, we are alive, you know, they're so good to us, you know, Russian good for us, you know. We school, we educated, this and that, you know, happy ending, happy good. Man, you know, There is no fucking happy good. I was in this room. I was with this guy in Moscow. I was in the street with him. He did this like he would want me to identify him. Man, I am scared to fucking identify you. I hope sincerely that you are going to be okay. That this video is not going to hurt you because I never meant any harm to you. I am actually quite worried now for you. But, you know, you need to understand one thing. This kind of stuff like this is what is scary about this stuff is that you're going to pull entire world, entire humanity down to the dust. Because when this is going to start, this, very soon, if not already, it started in Ukraine, but very soon this kind of stuff, it will, like the contagious disease, spread into other continents all around the world, and the entire humanity is going to find itself in the same location as it did before the practically end of this colonialism. You may not call one a slavery, but it was. Okay? So this is actually really, really a scary part about all this. I don't know what else I would tell you. Once you're going to start to see yourself in the foreigners, whether that be, if you love it so much, Russians or whatever, so much, that you're going to start to participate even by in articles like this, my God, and list your countries in these articles, you can wave your ass goodbye. Because, trust me, this kind of stuff loves to come back and bite and hunt. What they're doing is opening the front against you. You're going to find yourself in trouble for this stuff, for this kind of stuff, as a country, as a nation. I would tell the African leaders, the politicians, I would tell you, if you see people that want to do stuff like this, and it doesn't matter what side it is, I don't care. It works for me if you just stay at home. Don't go to help Ukraine. Don't do that kind of stuff. Just do your stuff. Work, education, that kind of stuff. You're going to do more for the world than any other way you possibly could. Because you do need to think about yourself. There was a lot of anger, all kinds of issues that went on in this MK Ultra that I saw these people. All kinds of people that spread hatred and all kinds of stuff. Boy, it was torture. I don't want to get into it. I understand that you need education. I understand that you need to go to Moscow. I understand that you need to pay for that education. But, you know, rather than give a shit reference to Ukraine, which was a case with a lot of students from Africa, and or listing yourself as dead during service at Wagner, you should be thinking about yourself, really about yourself, rather than participating in any wars anywhere. You are the longest exploited enslaved people here in Earth. And the biggest difference you're going to make is basically work with people that are trying to help you for your own good. You're going to do more for the world when you become educated than you're not participating in any war, in anywhere, in any kind of site. You're going to fuck the whole world up. Forget it. Education and working with the people that are trying to help you eventually will help save the world. The people, if I was a leader in Africa that want to participate in wars and bring the bad luck home like this, not like this, I'm going to actually even thank these guys. I thank these guys because I am alerted about basically what went on. The world now understands that they had to pay for their education in Moscow by listing themselves officially in a Wagner and then officially as dead. Now the world knows, thanks to these guys, that I see this is okay. I'm thankful to these guys, okay? It's good. I'm thankful to you, okay? But world should be alerted to this stuff, that whatever they go and study, they shouldn't be paying for the services for in a way like this, you know. Listing themselves and their countries basically is, you know, this is horror, basically. This is a fucking horror. I don't know what to tell you. Hope we're never going to see something like this in Africa. Try to see it other way. Try to see the situation through yourself. You put yourself on a picture and do your social justice through education and work. And that's going to do you, not only to you, but to the entire world, right? Because that's what you want. A whole lot. Much more than if you go and you participate anywhere. Okay, I don't have anything else I would say. He was really happy with his room. In this room, in this street here that you see, all through his smiling and he's all happy, he was not happy. There was a lot of misery out there. Okay? You don't want to this here with the Wagner. With the Wagner is a very sad story. Wagner started out with a really, really poor people that they collected from the prisons. People that they would not allow them to return back into society, whether they were they committed crimes. And oftentimes the biggest crime was a long-term unemployment. Because of whatever issues, because Russia is extremely political. And they would go and they would recruit these poor people from prisons, from the streets, and would throw them on the streets of Ukraine, basically to reduce the Russian deficit for social security, for the Russian social security. Simply by killing a lot of people like this, you save yourself from paying a lot of pensions when these people reach, if they reach a retirement age. That's one thing. You don't have to worry about the health benefits and so on. And, of course, use them in a useful way to hurt Ukrainian people as much as possible. Seeing yourself in this Wagner is a very, very sad story. Wagner is committed rape, killing of women, children, civilians. They exterminated throughout Ukraine. It's a very, very sad story. I think the story of what probably are this... who knows? I don't want to get into that stuff. Okay? There is nothing really to celebrate. If you are from Africa, just, you know, rather than to see yourself in that casket, it would do you much better if you watch this video, if you understand the meaning of this video. Now, he was arrested by Moscow police. Yes, Komenan Aboya fought in the ranks of Wagner. He said he was pardoned at the end of March and is currently undergoing a rehabilitation course. He fought bravely. Prigozhin provided no more information and declined further comment. Reuters could not reach Aboya. Aboya is... Aboya, whom I have met. I'm going to tell you how he physically looked. Very weak. It would be very tough for him to fight anywhere. He was not fit to fight in Wagner. This is exactly not the material the Russians would use. Actually, any kind of military would use, really, that is trained military. He was not trained. He would not pass into a military. He was really, really, he struggled with the things. But he is the only one, you know, he is the only one that survived. You know why he is the only one that survived? He is the only one that survived because he was the only one that served in Wagner. As for the other two students here that you see, this here that you see, these guys did not serve. These guys enlisted themselves and most likely were never ever dispatched anywhere on a front line, even, I would say. I'd love to see these guys even in uniforms. I would love to see these guys even in uniforms. They were much stronger, built differently, and they could serve in a military, in a serious military, contrary to the guy I demonstrated you. The guy that I demonstrated was so, he struggled. And he gained a lot of sympathy from the Russians for it. And so, you know, this kind of stuff was just done basically like, you know, it's like building some kind of relations that are actually really, really schizophrenic relations. The idea here is to trigger your mind to see yourself in Russia in some kind of glorification or something, admitting you in something that you have done for the Russia and seeing yourself, you know, under some flag over there where the sword is up on it, in a casket, involved community in, you know, making news, depicting themselves as, you know, like we did have this and that, even if it's not true, it doesn't matter. And, you know, the politic, I told you, politic already is a schizophrenia. But, you know, this is a bad, bad, bad schizophrenia. This schizophrenia like this doesn't have a good end. Shackle on your wrist. Chain around your neck. This is always a bad case of schizophrenia. Always a bad, bad, bad case of schizophrenia. You will know them. Not by British boats, not by French boats, not by Belgian boats, by German boats. When they come, you will know them by their competition they're going to send. They already did. You already started to take sides. I should say sides. You already started to take sides. You started already with the competition. Sad story. Very, very sad story. Now it's more sad than the funeral that you see over there. Now it's more sad than the funeral.